Hello, this is Hirodov YouTube channel, and now I will review the most powerful Amiga computer to date, the AmigaOne X1000. The machine is available for purchase starting at 2656.25 euro. For that price you get the following hardware. Black Pearl PC case, 80x form factor. Pretty big one, so much space for anything inside. Dual core PWR efficient PA6T-1682M 1.8 GHz power ISA version 2.04 plus CPU. Pretty fast. Coprocessor Xena clocked at 500 MHz. X-Core XS1 L2 124 SDS. 80 Radeon card or AMD Radeon. 7.1 audio. You are hearing right now. Four DDR2 SD RAM slots. I am currently using only one of them with 1 GB. And additionally I have 256 MB of RAM. There, so total 1.2 GB of RAM. 10 2.0 USB slots, you see 8 here and 2 additional here. One gigabit Ethernet, additionally with card. Two PCI by 16 ports. Two PCIe by 16 slots, 1 by 16 or 2 by 8. Two PCIe by 1 slot and two PCI slots and one XORO slot. Plus compact flash here slot. 4 SATA Revision 2.0 ports. 1 PATA connector. And 1 JTAG connector. In Amiga terms, this is quite amazing. Compared to my microAmigaOne computer, it's at least twice as fast, has much more memory, more ports, and more of everything. It's only slightly bigger than the microAmigaOne. What I really like in my basic AmigaOne X1000 configuration is the big amount of RAM that I use when developing and put everything inside the RAM disk for testing. Another plus is the DVI, Digital Video Interface Output, meaning that I can easily grab the video output with external digital frame grabber and record awesome high quality videos directly out of the Amiga. Here it is, DVI connector. There is RGB as well, but it's analog and DVI is giving much better quality. On the software side, it runs Amiga OS 4.1 quite nicely with fast booting time. Let me boot it for you. And utilizing almost all the resources. Unfortunately, the Amiga operating system and all the related programs run on single core, while the machine is dual core, meaning that almost half of the CPU power is staying idle. On the plus side, all my software that I have collected since 2004 when I first acquired my AmigaOne computer with Amiga OS 4 works faster and I can develop even more software. The Amiga SDK is quite easy to set up. My favorite text editor of choice is Signoset. Signoset Professional. That I use since the early 1990s. I wrote countless of programs and text documents on this. And I can open any document now. Including binary. In 2016, the AmigaOne is still giving pretty enough to stay up to date in the digital epoch and manner where internet connection is a must, surfing the internet, online social activities and media consuming are part of our daily life. Many people don't watch TV or listen to broadcasted radio anymore, while they are preferred to choose by themselves what to watch directly on their computer, and the Amiga got it covered. For the retro game players, they are emulated all the Amiga games with the use of Run in UAA. Double click on 68K program to run it in AUAA, or drop 68K program here to change how it's run. Plus, I have ported the Hatari emulator, which emulates Atari ST computer. There are also emulators for Sinclairs, Sega Mega Drive, Commodore 64, 8-bit Ataris, Suncoop, Apple, Dragon, PlayStation, DOS, Macintosh, Amstrad, Sega Master System, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance, and many, many more. So for retro gaming, you have it all available. With the use of Amiga input, I am playing directly with USB joysticks. As you can see, on the newer games from their native PowerPC games. For example, Amiga Racer. That run amazingly fast, have pretty nice graphics in high resolution and tempered CD quality music. There are also Smoking Guns, Gorky 17, and many, many more.
You will not copy this game.
Hurricane, Cube, Free Surf, F1 Spirit, Super Mario War, to name a few.
Amiga Tech Incorporated proudly presents
On the video editing side, one of the fields where the Amiga was quite popular, the choices are not that broad anymore. There are command-based video editing tools Some of the software can record videos, there is a screen capture software, and for example the Oric emulator can output AV recordings of your emulated session that is ready to direct upload to YouTube. But there are no NLE video editors, only Blender. Not easy to use GUI-driven interfaces for editing, managing and encoding videos. On the video replay side, however, the MPR plays quite nicely with movies and I have watched many videos with it. For audio editing, another field where the Amiga was quite largely used, especially for tracker music, there are MIDI-based software editors called Bars and Pipes and Horny. I connect and control directly my Korg PA50 professional music arranger with the use of USB to MIDI cable. There are also Pro Tracker and Heavy Tracker for tracker composed music, even the so-called Tube Tunes, MP3 encoders, Audio Evolution and more. For software developers, the Amiga OS4 SDK is freely available with the GCC GNU Compiler Collection, meaning that you can develop in C, C++, Objective-C and more. CDL2 library was ported to Amiga OS4 recently, meaning that even the recent multi-platform software will come as well. For me, it means I have to start on developing again while doing videos as well. For the other programmers, there are other choices, for example Perl, PHP, Python, Pascal, Basic and more. I have big experience with emulating another computer platforms on the Amiga and the AmigaOne X1000, I do it even faster and better with it. While for example there is not very feature-rich Apple II emulators for AmigaOne computers, I use Apple PC for MS-DOS by running DOSBox emulator and then the Apple II emulator. The emulation is at 100% speed without frame skips, even though the use of emulator in emulator. That's how advanced and fast are the later Amiga models. While the Higgs 5000 is coming soon, it will be even more amazing. The X1000 is quite good machine that gives enough bang for the buck and gave me countless hours of entertainment and will continue to do so. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to Herodov YouTube channel, leave your like, comments, share the video and spread it. It really helps me when producing new videos and making more enjoyable experience for you, the viewers. Thank you!